don't use SPM, it's fantastic. I'm really overjoyed about that. It will make life a lot easier for people using standard edition. But let's have a look at demo 5. So, where I did the bind variable peaking thing before, I'm doing the same thing again. Index plan, scan plan. But I'm going to use a baseline to lock this down. Gather information, get the histograms, get a frequency histogram. We're now running the SQL, and we can see the plan. Table access full. Now I'm going to capture a baseline. And I'm going to do the cheap and cheerful way by switching on the init aura parameter to capture all baselines. There's no baseline there at the moment. Let's switch it on and run the SQL. Now, so set the optimized capture SQL plan baselines to true, is what I'm doing it here. When 12.0 came out, Oracle switched this on by default. And we all said, this is not a sensible idea. When you release 12.1 GA, can we not have this set to true by default? We don't want to baseline our entire systems, thank you. So they switched it off. You've got to run a plan, your SQL twice to be captured as a baseline in this method, but any SQL that is run twice, so if you run it once, it's unique, it doesn't care. If you run it twice, it goes, hang on a sec, you use this SQL a lot, therefore I'm going to capture a baseline. And if we go, I'll switch it off to false, and we go over here, and we can see we've got a baseline here. It's enabled, it's accepted, and this is the SQL text, which is the text that we're running before for the bind variables. Now if we flush the shared pool, run the query, we get table access full with the input of scan plan. If we now flush the shared pool again and run it for index plan, we still get a full scan. And if we look, we can see a SQL plan baseline was used for this statement. It knows that it is only allowed to use the plans that we say it's allowed to use. And if we look in the baselines, we can see we've now got two. This one is enabled and accepted, our scan plan. This one is enabled and not accepted. So what's the optimizer optimized, passed the code and realized that there was a plan with a lower cost, it's not allowed to use it unless we say it's allowed to use it. We can have a look at the plans, and we can see this one, this plan ending in 1E, is the table access full, and the plan ending in 811 is the index range scan, but this plan here has not been accepted. We can now evolve the plan, doing an evolve report. So we evolve the report, we do an evolve, and it says, oh right, okay, number of plans processed, we've got a couple of findings and one recommendation. It can see the plan it's testing and the one it's testing it against. And it's captured the input bind variable as well for the plan. So it's testing it with the actual inputs that we have. So the baseline plan is this with this cost, the new plan's got this time frame and this cost. And because we told it to, the plan was automatically accepted. It says consider accepting the plan, but it's actually just gone and accepted it. It then shows us the plans, and we can now show it being used. And now we can see we've got an index range scan and the 811 plan has been used. Capture that, and if we go and look, we can see that the 811 plan has been accepted by the evolve command. And I think that's really rather cute. So, there are other ways to capture baselines. You don't just have to capture them at all, so we can capture them from any cursor in the cache. We can load them through a SQL tuning set. We can migrate a stored outline to a baseline. That's fantastic. Everyone with standard edition with the new bits coming in, wonderful. And we can copy them from system to system. So you can actually create your baselines on a copy of production and drop them into production. This was the first time I actually used baselines. This is a real system issue. We had the same piece of SQL, sometimes running in a few seconds, sometimes running in 2 minutes. And the problem was this SQL had to run every minute. So running in 2 minutes was a bit of a problem. A lot of a problem. This is, you can see, it's a rather old version of Enterprise Manager, and we just went into the tuning, we could see the plan, we told it to baseline it, we just grabbed it in the cursor cache, we told it to baseline it, and thereafter it just ran in the few seconds. It's absolutely fabulous. It took us about 30 minutes, and 29 of those minutes were getting permission from management to do it. Now, you might go to a lot of trouble to restrict your plans to ensure that we've got a nice, neat, tidy set of baselines. So overnight, when Oracle runs the SQL Tuning Advisor auto task, it runs SPM auto evolve, which automatically evolves all of the baselines. All of your plans may change overnight. It's precisely what I do not want to happen. If I've spent a long time capturing and evolving and moving baselines around, I don't want Oracle doing it itself. I recommend that by default you switch this off if you're going to use baselines, because then you've got control over when you evolve them. I asked Oracle to switch this off by default on about 10 occasions now, and they've still said no. I don't know what the... Genuinely don't know what they're thinking. Anyway, I think I'm pretty much on time there. I'm slightly over. Oops. Execution plans are important. If you're in an OLTP environment, you probably want consistency. Baselining is really useful. But if you are going to use baselining, keep looking at them, evolve them. You probably don't want to let it all go evolve, but keep working with it. Has anyone got any questions? Silence. Awesome. Thank you very much.